These people clearly don't know what they are talking about. When you say that the External Affairs Ministry has failed, well, fine. Then can you suggest a way of success? You cannot, you can just say straight off, External Affairs Ministry, there's a crisis and so on. Very good. Now tell us, what is the way to avoid that crisis? What is the way to actually ensure that Kulbhushan Jadhav gets back? We have to remember that we are dealing with Pakistan, a country that does not have any sense of ethics, a country that uses every underhand method to do whatever it does. Now here is a man who was kidnapped. He's a retired naval officer who's a businessman. Here he's been kidnapped, he's been sold to the Pakistanis, he's been tortured, a false confession has been extracted for him, and you tell the world that he's a terrorist. Now what kind of person are you to do it, particularly if you are an Indian parliamentarian? Okay, you don't know about it. If you don't know about it, find out. Find out what the actual facts are and then tell the world what you have to say. To do this is actually insulting yourself, insulting your political party, insulting the nation, and insulting Kulbhushan Jadhav,
yes,
who was working for the country, who was working for the country as a naval officer, and now suddenly you call him a terrorist. What kind of person are you to actually do that?
No, not just that, Sanjoy. What stands out is that for them, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter that two Indian women were left there absolutely helpless at the mercy of these Pakistanis and the way they ill-treated them. It doesn't matter. There is no ire amongst these polity. It just doesn't matter to them. Athar also joins Aditi Anand Narayanan. And what stands out is that just because they have a bone to pick with the current disposition, they forget the cause for India. They forget to unite for India, Aditi and Athar.
Well, yes, absolutely. In fact, we saw the reactions coming in from members of the parliament like Veerappa Moily and Naresh Agarwal. Naresh Agarwal clearly crossing all limits by calling Kulbhushan Jadhav a terrorist, when on one side the government of India has been condemning the kind of reaction that we are getting in from Pakistan for the manner in which they humiliated and harassed the mother and the wife of Kulbhushan Jadhav when they had gone to visit him. And on the other side, also interestingly, Anand, in Lok Sabha, when we saw various members of the parliament raising the issue of Kulbhushan Jadhav, they were unanimously condemning it. Mallikarjun Kharge, another Congress MP, was one of those who said that there should be an official statement coming in from the government of India, and we condemn the manner in which Pakistani government and Pakistani agencies have been harassing and humiliating the family members of Kulbhushan Jadhav. But clearly there seems to be a divide within the opposition parties, one on the side of Naresh Agarwal and Veerappa Moily, who are condemning and questioning the government of India, and on the other side we have unanimously all opposition parties coming together in the Lok Sabha and seeking answers from the government of India, Athar.
The fact that Juhi Singh, spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, has already come out and distanced herself and her party as well from the statement, saying our national president, that is Akhilesh Yadav, will try and take cognizance of it and see what exactly is he said. The fact of the matter is, yesterday, Anand, we were talking about how this entire exercise of letting the family meet Mr. Jadhav under those intimidating stage circumstances, the only purpose they wanted to serve, of course, was to push the narrative. I refer you yet again to the MEA statement and, of course, some off-record conversations I had yesterday. The entire drama was staged to push the narrative of completely unsubstantiated and unverified claims by Pakistan that Mr. Jadhav and his alleged activities. The fact that now people, leaders inside parliament like Mr. Naresh Agarwal, are now actually aiding in pushing that narrative. This is what the MEA had to be on guard against. This is what India had to be on guard against, really.
Yes.
And now within, inside parliament, on the floor of the house, people like Naresh Agarwal are saying and doing that, perpetuating that narrative, clearly is just playing into the hands of Pakistan.
Yes.
We might as well give them the game.
And not just that, none of these leaders who try at the drop of a hat for every other issue take to social media and Twitter, have multiple questions to ask. None of them noticed the treatment that had been meted out. None of them reacted to the change of clothes. None of them reacted to know whether they were all right. None of them reacted to it. Even after we put out details after details, none of them questioned Pakistan's commitment and whether it really honored a commitment it made to the people of this country. And that is where it hurts, that our politicians cannot unite for the country just because of their petty ideological or political divides.